Hello, I'm Jashikins, and those who are spiritual or religious, and yes, there is a difference between the two, but that's a whole nother set of videos. Anyways, they have two realms to deal with, the spiritual and the mortal. And the spiritual, it's demons, gods, goddesses, Buddha. It really depends on your own set of beliefs in the spiritual realm, what's in there and how to act. Then besides that, those people have to deal with the mortal realm, which is politics, science, physics, cars, airplanes, etc. Anyways, both of those realms are deep and complex. And a question the spiritual and religious people have to face is, which is more important? Which one should I follow? And that's what this video is going to discuss, which one is more important. And to tell you where I stand on this subject, I myself am spiritual, but I'm not going to discuss all my different beliefs and why I believe them because, one, it is deeply and highly personal, and two, that's not the focus of today's video.
It is your destiny.
Fuck my destiny.
Sarkisian returned my call. We'll meet about selling the Turk.
He still got it? When's the meeting?
Tomorrow morning.
Meaning that this news could have waited?
Now, the mortal realm is the physical realm. It contains politics, any branch of science, how and why your application is accepted or rejected, how the internet works, any number of things. And it's really the easiest realm to deal with because this is the one realm that can be checked and double-checked. Scientists can run a test, and another group of scientists can run the same test, and if their results match, they know that their hypothesis is correct. And yeah, it's an easy one to deal with, but at the same time, there are still mysteries. And this could be considered the most important because this is the realm everyone lives in and can agree upon. Now, for those who are spiritual or religious, they have to deal with the spiritual realm, which is really hard to convey to someone who has a different belief system of you. Because while the spiritual realm is good for your soul, to tell you how to live a good life so you'll have a good afterlife, telling you how to communicate with the supernatural, blah blah blah, the fact is, if someone believes differently than you, it is hard to speak to that person without sounding crazy. And people can view the same information and turn around different ways depending on what they want to believe. And at the same time, the spiritual realm could be considered the most important because this is your soul we're talking about, your fucking soul. It matters a lot more than the mortal realm to some people. So, which realm contains the most important truth? Is it the mortal realm or the spiritual realm? In my opinion, as someone who is spiritual, you need to be equally aware of both, and both are equally important. You can't live in the mortal without living in the spiritual, and you can't live in the spiritual without living in the mortal. Know why? Because you're a human being right now. It doesn't matter what you were before or what you will be. It matters what you are now. And you need to learn to accept that. You need to learn to accept things that happen in the mortal realm. You need to learn to accept things in the spiritual realm. And yet, some people, like Christians, believe you need to live in the world but not be of the world. Which just it cuts off part of you. I'm more partial to the Native American belief that believes there are these sections of the medicine wheel that we all must live in and all must accept. and they are physical and spiritual, including some others, and you need to live in all of them or else you are incomplete. You need to live. You need to live fully and lively. And you can't cut off one without cutting off the other. So you need to learn the mortal realm rules and the spiritual realm rules.
Atheists, you are so damn lucky. Know why? You only have the mortal realm to deal with, and it's confusing as hell. And there are unanswered questions. And yet, the mortal realm can actually be double-checked, and science is in it, and... wow. But anyways, to the religious people that have a set of beliefs that say that only if you believe a certain set of beliefs will you be saved? Listen, I don't mind if you talk to me about your beliefs, if you pray for me, because those only take up time, but at the same time, they don't hurt me. I don't mind them. It's interesting to find out what you believe. But it's when you start trying to convert me. Because listen, I've reached my set of beliefs by deep meditation, by looking inside myself, looking to facts, and it's taken many years for me to grow into my set of beliefs. And even if I end up believing your set of beliefs, right now, it's just pissing me off. So stop it. Stop it. And until next video, goodbye.
It irks me when I get burned and I realize I don't get hurt. It always, it seems I've lost my way. When I feel you, it's not enough and I need you. Shun my touch, I notice the season's ripe for change. How